Hello and welcome. My name is Brooke Shaden. I'm a fine art photographer and we're diving into Photoshop today. So I've got a really interesting image to show you, and this is specifically an image using multiple subjects and sort of entwining them together in a weird way. So funny story about this image, we being myself and a group of about 18 people, we're all exploring this like semi-abandoned school. It was kind of weird. And we were in this space and I had been really uninspired that day, like just kind of feeling low and not like myself. And I just wanted to create so badly. And I remember just going all over the place. I couldn't figure out what I wanted to do. And then I saw these sort of, it was sort of like a stadium with like risers where people would sit. And I was so drawn to this space. It was like the least interesting part of the whole room, but I really wanted to create there. So I asked three of my friends if they wouldn't mind stripping down to their underwear and just entwining their limbs together. And it was hilarious and we cracked up through the whole thing. And I love when an image turns out like this, but you know the story behind it, because dark art does not have to be dark to make. Honestly, it can be really fun. So that's what we did, and I want to break this down for you. So this is the finished image, but let's go all the way to the bottom of the layers and see what it looked like before. So we've got a couple more heads in there than we did before. I love the behind the scenes of this image. It's hilarious to me. So let's start by getting rid of those heads. And this was just a simple matter of clone stamping them out, and that's what I did. So I got rid of the extra heads because I just wanted the body parts and one featured subject in this picture. And then I added on the left side of the frame, which I then modified by making it brighter to fit in better. And then the other side. And then I sort of expanded the frame out wherever it was missing just by cloning and sort of blending the wall together. So let's move on now. What's going on with these? I'm trying to blend the wall better. So I'm darkening, lightening, just creating this sense of subject standing out from the background, which was really important for this image because if we go back all these steps, it's really, of course they stand out. There's nothing else in this picture but people, but I really want them to pop in such a way that they don't just blend as the same color with the wall. I really wanted to create more separation. So this step in particular is really important. You can even see on the mask that what I've done here is I've darkened everything but my subject, and that's going to be an important theme in this image to create the most impact. You can see it happening again here, adding light to my subject instead of just not darkening my subject. Adding this really extreme vignette, and this particular vignette, if we open the curve, is very important because it's actually taking the blacks and skewing them massively gray and then darkening the outside edges as well. And this essentially gets rid of detail. So if I click that layer on and off again, you can see that there's so much less detail in the outside edges. Again, bringing the attention to the subject that has the most detail. Brightening up that subject again, adding a little bit of color in, again, changing not the subject, but just the outside, and this time with color. So bringing warmth into the outside, but not onto the subjects because they're already very warm in tone. Just adding more light, refining, adding more light, texture for me always comes at the end, and our final adjustment. So this was a really weird photo to create, but it's really amazing to do the weird things if you can while you're creating to see how it turns out. I mean, it might be a little bit weird to ask three of your friends to get in their underwear and intertwine their limbs together, but it's a memorable experience to be certain. And we still talk about it. And this was 3 years ago now that we shot this. So I think it's totally worth it to be as weird as you can be while you're creating, whether that's with your camera or whatever you use to create or in Photoshop. I hope that if this shows you anything, that it's worth it to do it originally in camera and then enhance it in post. Have a wonderful creative week, and I'll see you next time.